Hey there, lads and ladies, it is Petrifying Pumpkins, and welcome to another episode of PSVR News. This one, just a couple of things to talk about, but some particularly interesting stuff to talk about when it comes to Hitman VR, which I think a lot of us are looking forward to, the big game of 2021. So without further ado, let's just jump right into it. Okay, so a few days ago, developers of Hitman 3, which is coming out January 2021, as I said, had a kind of a Q&A type, or more of an interview, I should say, a live stream type thing, where they went over the development process of how they brought Hitman to virtual reality, the kind of complications they faced and the adjustments they made. So there was a lot of kind of interesting tidbits there, and I made a list of them. So I think we're just going to go through some of the most like interesting things that they talked about, including the big elephant in the room, I think, which is the Move controller support, which is absent. They do talk about that. There is a bit of light at the end of the tunnel in that regard. So when they were talking about like why they brought Hitman to VR in the first place, basically they love Hitman, they love virtual reality, they wanted to bring these two things together, and they thought that because Hitman is like a slow-paced stealth type game, rather than moving around the place, jumping, parkour, speeding around corners or whatever, it really fits the virtual reality experience well, because, you know, such a low risk of motion sickness and stuff like that when you're just slowly walking around the place. So that was a big reason for us. They talked about like the enhancements that VR brings to us. So even without them doing anything, even with them just bringing VR to Hitman, they said they were noticing things, even in the old Hitman games, like the Paris level from 5 years ago or whatever, that they did not see before. One of the developers gave the example of the fact that there was like a scaffolding or something in one of the levels, and you could see gaps. Whereas when you're playing that flat, you kind of just walk past the scaffolding, no big deal. When you're in virtual reality, you don't have that 3D camera to see around corners, so you're actually peeking through the gaps in the scaffolding, and you can shoot through them to hit guards on the other side, things that you wouldn't have been able to do before without virtual reality. So stuff like that gets enhanced. They also gave an example of maybe like crouching under tables. You can see feet walking along, so you get an idea of like who's there. Again, the third person camera is gone, so in a way it makes the game harder, but because you've got all these other kind of gameplay elements being introduced that maybe weren't there before, it kind of balances it out, so it's kind of a different experience, not necessarily a harder one, although it could be. But that does sound really cool, I think. So they also talked about NPC interactions. So when they brought this to VR first, NPCs would only really react, because you couldn't really touch NPCs in the base game, or in the flat game I should say. You could bump into them, but you couldn't reach out and touch them. So they had to like add this enhanced reactions to the NPCs. So now we've seen it before with the crowbar, that's probably in the trailer playing behind me right now, where you can tap the shoulder. But they've actually programmed this in such a way that if you tap the right shoulder, NPC will turn to the right, and the same for the left. So you can, you know, humorous moments ahead with just that little silly kind of a thing. But you know, if you slap them in the face, they'll react, whereas before they wouldn't react because they only ever reacted to you bumping into them. So these are like additions that they've added to the game, changes to the AI, and potentially new experiences that you just couldn't possibly get playing flat. And apparently, I'm just going to throw this out there, but you can stroke the guards. They don't like us. They won't immediately attack you unless you keep doing it. So that's just like a little example of like, you know, the kind of, you know how it is when you're in VR, you just want to touch things and do weird things and see how you can test the AI. But so yeah, if you want to give them a massage or whatever, you better be like in and out real quick, you know, because they're going to snap eventually. So another thing that they talked about, another thing that they had to kind of change, was basically in the flat version, the enemy lines of sights were kind of all based around Agent 47's torso. So when they brought it over, they were peeking around the corner, but because his head was not being spotted by the NPCs, they never reacted. So they have changed that in such a way now so that the enemies will detect your head and even your arms. But again, because it's VR, because it's new experiences, you can use this to your advantage in kind of. So let's say you're hiding somewhere, you can stick your hand out behind like a door frame or over a table or whatever you're hiding behind, and if the audio cue starts playing that like maybe a guard is getting suspicious, you just pull your hand back. All of a sudden you know that there is a guard in that area, so you've lost the third person camera, but you've gained this new kind of skill or sense, you know, to kind of balance things out again, which is interesting. Next up, they talked about like tossing weapons and tossing objects in the world and interacting with them in a way that you just wouldn't before. So the example was, apparently in these games, If a guard sees spots, a weapon discarded on the floor, they'll be like, huh, what's this? Pick it up, bring it to like a specific location on the map or whatever. So now you can like throw these guns. The developer gave the example, he wanted to throw it over a wall, but it got stuck on top of the wall, so he kind of failed. But then his fellow developer said, hey, why don't you use your wrench and knock it over the wall? So he pulled out his wrench and then he was able to poke it over the wall. It fell over to the other side, and then the guard is like, hey, what's this? You know, so it was like an example of, again, just like physics, playing with physics, stuff like that, that you just don't guess flat. So even though the developers have said that a lot of the levels and all that kind of stuff just look fantastic without them touching anything, just the way they are, there are notes and details that they haven't before, that doesn't mean that they haven't changed things for virtual reality in order to enhance the experience. So the example given is that if you're hiding behind a door, apparently that's just way more intense and stuff than it would be in Flask, which you can imagine the way things were, maybe there was geometry behind the door blocking us and not letting you get there like as easily as you could. So they removed geometry, got it out of the way so that you can, you know, have a better virtual reality gameplay experience. They then talked a little bit about audio, in particular sound effects, and how, you know, 3D audio, you're going to want to be seeing, or not seeing, but you're going to want to be listening to where footsteps are coming from. They're going to be a lot more important, because you're not going to be having that 3D camera like we keep talking about to know if a guard is coming towards you. You'll be listening for footsteps to know how many there are. Again, you're going to have to maybe rely on audio a lot more than you would have flat. They talked about the enhancements of physical interactions thanks to being in virtual reality and having the motion control. The examples they gave were like, you know, just smashing glass cabinets with the crowbar, which is apparently very satisfying. A confession booth, which has like a cloth in front of it that you can just like move aside with your hand. They say that's very cool, impressive. I think we saw as well like beads coming down in the door, and you can like part them and go through. So lots of little things like that. They're there in the flat version, but you're just interacting with them in a different way, in a more controlled way, and definitely more immersive way, I would say. Also, they spoke about this kind of prototype feature, we'll call it, that they have right now. Now, it's not guaranteed to make it into the finished product. I suppose it depends on if it's fun enough or not. They're talking about how if you're in disguise as a barman, you know, you're wiping down the surface of the bar, but if you don't do that, then the, you know, the guard will get suspicious. You'll hear that sound effect, so you have to keep wiping, physically wiping the counter down with your actual hand, rubbing a cloth along the counter. Again, not something you can do flat other than like pressing a button or whatever, but in virtual reality you get that extra immersion. Now, of course, that might not work well, it might not be fun after a certain amount of time or doing certain activities, so it might not make it into the game. But they did feel comfortable enough to talk about it, so maybe, like, they seemed, you know, pretty excited about it, so we might see that. So now we move to the elephant in the room, as we talked about earlier, is the Move controller support. Basically, they reiterated what they said in the Reddit Ask Me Anything, where all the motion control is going to be done with the DualShock 4. Now, surprisingly, they actually name dropped Firewall Zero Hour. They said they played a lot of that. I guess they didn't have their hands on an aim controller, because they said they used the DualShock 4 in that game and they were surprised with how well it worked. So based on that, they were like, you know, Hitman is a big game, we need a lot of buttons, you need a lot of movement. And another reason that they kind of gave was that they want you to be able to be comfortable, sit for a long period of time and not having to worry about standing up or whatever. Even though standing is an option if you want. I know a lot of people might roll their eyes saying, listen, I can stand up for hours, I don't need to be, you know, or we could sit down and play with the Move controllers. But the good news here is that they did say they haven't ruled it out, they are exploring us, but it's just not a priority, it sounds like. So maybe we can expect it further down the line. I suspect that when they bring Hitman to the PC platforms, they're going to be making a control scheme that's going to fit the two motion controllers then, and that's when they'll probably bring it to us. If I had to guess, it seems kind of maybe like it makes the most sense. So hopefully that maybe raises the spirits of people who are really disappointed with no Move controllers. Like, there is a bit of hope at the end of the tunnel, a bit of light at the end of the tunnel. And they did say to the people who are like, you know, DualShock 4 motion control is going to be trash, they suspect that we'll be pleasantly surprised with how well the DualShock 4's motion controls actually work in this game. You know, that remains to be seen. Maybe it will, you know. And that is kind of all I wanted to say about Hitman. I mean, there's a lot of stuff there to take in. It's kind of exciting hearing about all these kind of additions to VR, all this extra immersion that maybe we can expect. it is, you know, I suppose the move control is still kind of up in the air, but it's not like a definite ruled out kind of a thing. So I think that's good news. I think I'm still going to get it straight away. I think I'm still going to play it with the DualShock 4. And if the moves control comes out later on and it's better, then that's all well and good. I'll be happy. So yeah, let me know in the comments below what you thought about this new information that's come to light recently. Is this giving you a bit of hope? Or are you like, nope, not playing this until the moves come out, or whatever. Let me know in the comments below. And let me just quickly move on to the next topic. So this is about Swordman VR. Now, this game is coming, supposedly, to both PC VR and PlayStation VR this month. I've seen some people say the 10th of September. I've seen some people say the 15th. The Sin Studio themselves put out the trailer. An official trailer. In the description it says TBA, but for some reason they don't specify an actual days in the description, which I think is a bit strange because that trailer just came out yesterday. If it's coming out on the 10th, then surely that should be locked in. It shouldn't be TBA. But what I will say is that this game actually looks pretty damn cool, but this comes with a caveat. So basically the gameplay that you're seeing behind me here is what I can see is that this game is trying its best to emulate Blade and Sorcery, where it's got that physical based combat. Now it doesn't quite look as polished or as feature rich maybe as that game, but it does look cool. We don't really have anything like this on PSVR, which is why it's extra exciting, I think, for me. But the big caveat here is that it's been made by Sin Studios. Now these guys, I don't want to talk shit, but these are the guys who made Warzone VR, which might have been one of the worst received games I've ever heard tell of on the PSVR. In particular, the PSVR port was utter trash. So while I am excited for this game because the gameplay that we've seen here looks really cool, I'm definitely going to be waiting and like holding back to see you know, how this PSVR port is going to be before I sing its praises completely. But you know, keep an eye on this. I think this, you know, one to watch. It's already kind of suspicious with the date thing going on. Is it this month? Is it not this month? I don't know. That's really all I wanted to say about this because I don't really know too much about it. I know it is like narrative driven. There is a story, there's voice acting, there's like a mixture of all different cultures going on here. You got like Mongolian warriors and samurai and knights and all that kind of crack. But yeah, I guess the only thing I want to say about this is to just be a little bit careful about this one based solely on Warzone VR. Now maybe the developers have, you know, really buckled down and put a lot of effort into this compared to Warzone, and it looks that way from the gameplay. It looks really cool. But just be careful is all I'm saying about that one. And with that, I will end this video. Thank you very much for watching. But before I go, let me give a shout out to my Patreon supporters whose names are on the screen as I speak. Thanks to their generosity, they're keeping this channel going. In particular, let me give a shout out to Pete Hawkins, Daniel the Pumpkin Patch Kid, Chopped517, Tradition, and Crumb. Thank you very much for that generosity, lads. I really do appreciate it. If you'd like to be a Patreon too, head on over to patreon.com/petrifyingpumpkins if you're interested. If not, I'll also be delighted with likes, comments, subscribes, all that usual shite. You know how it is yourself. And lastly, let me give a big thank you to Decepticon for letting me use his music in all the videos I make. Head on over to Decepticon.com to check out his music. The link will be in the description below. And with that, I will end this video. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Stay moist.